what should be the rate of depreciation, how I will deal with all type of situation. In isolation, I did all this exercise at the ICAI, but maybe I will not say the not proper coordination. We did a lot of good coordination with the department or venue, but finally the rules are not yet formulated. The norms are not formulated, and finally it is deferred. The key questions for our country. Still, it is not notified in the sense the date is not notified. And unless until date is not notified, it is not applicable to any of the corporate of this country. I also would like to tell you about this accounting standards, that some of the standards are only reporting standards. You need not to do any accounting treatment of the transactions or events. You have to only report it. For example, their accounting standard deals with the segment reporting. Take an example of the ITC. All you know ITC, it's a company basically in the business of tobacco. But over the period, they also now diversified, and they are in the hotel and tourism, they are in the paperboard business, they are in the agro commodities, they are in the FMCG, all these Ashirwad Atta and Bingo chips and Sunfeast biscuits are the product of ITC. All these ITC Sheraton in the major cities of this country. Now, as an investor of the in the company of ITC, where I have the 5,000 shares invested, I want to know the revenue pattern of ITC. And you will be amazed to know this, that more than 70% of the revenue is coming from only cigarettes. If you take, it is around 23,000 crore turnover of the company in a year. If I delete excise duty, it comes around 16,000 crore. And out of 16,000 crore, 70% of the business is coming because of tobacco. Now, accounting standard says, when you are having a diversified business, where you have the product segment or the geographical segment, where your risk and return depends on the product or the geographical location, you have to report to the investors. If tomorrow government decide to ban tobacco in this country, what would be the fate of this ITC? Where would the investor go? The share will completely collapse in a day. So you must know the type of risk you are taking when you are investing money in the company. You must know the revenue pattern. If something goes wrong, then what would be your line of action? Obviously, you are expecting a higher return. That's why you are in the equity market, otherwise not. So some of the accounting standards do not require any accounting treatment of the events and transaction that is occurring during the financial year. But this is, you have to report to the investor. What is your EPS, earning per share? You must tell to investors. If I take an example of a company where the EPS is rupees 10 and the face value is rupees 1, and the market price of that share is 200 rupees, what is the meaning of all these figures? We have Professor P.K. Jain today, where he will have all the ratios. Obviously, he will have the focus on the PE and the significance of the PE. When you will see a summary report card of any of the company, maybe on the moneyrediff.com or the moneycontrol.com, definitely you will find the PE of each company. What is the meaning of this PE?